Welcome everyone! Today we're going to learn the tools for drawing different sorts of lines and shapes in ProMotion NG. The tools for drawing simple geometric shapes are lines, squares, and circles. Variants of the tools allow you to create outlines or filled shapes. The tools have keyboard shortcuts like V for straight lines, C for circles, and R for squares. It may happen that if you use a shortcut, a dialog appears showing you two functions the shortcut is assigned to. This is mostly done to let the user select which operation to use for shortcuts that also exist in other software but are assigned to other functions there. This can help you use shortcuts for the same functions as you are used to with other software packages. You can generally explore and modify any shortcut in Menu, File, Keyboard Shortcuts. To draw a straight line, we just select the corresponding tool and click and drag on the canvas from the starting point in the desired direction. As with every tool, there are a couple of options. Dot every nth pixel will allow us to place the brush dots with a given distance of pixels instead of having a continuous line. Number of total dots makes sure that only the given number of dots are drawn, no matter how long the line is. See the bottom line in the main window to find extra key control options. Holding the Shift key enables a lock mode so that you can create perfect horizontal or vertical lines, or to automatically snap to certain angles. There's the isometric mode, which lets you snap to typical angles used for isometric perspective, as we will see later. Even Segment will make sure that every segment of the line uses the same number of pixels. This is something that makes lines look cleaner for pixel-precise artwork. Isometric drawing is a graphical representation of a three-dimensional object reduced to two dimensions through a parallel projection based on three axes, maintaining its proportions in each of the three dimensions of space, height, width, and length. It's used with technical drawings or games that give the illusion of depth and space. While with technical drawings, the angles like 30 degrees and 60 degrees are a standard, in pixel art we use angles that can use a fixed number of pixels per line segment, like 2 to 1 giving 22.5 degrees or 1 to 1 giving 45 degrees. In this cube example, we are using the 2 to 1 isometric perspective, and we can use the corresponding snapping modes to draw all our lines perfectly. When used in games, these objects can then be turned into square tiles of a certain size if required. I recently worked on content for an isometric perspective video game, and we considered two options, the 2 to 1 ratio, which corresponds to the standard isometric angles, or we could use a 4 to 1 ratio for a scenario where the objects are displayed with an increased depth. Another important extra key is the Control key. It makes the respective tool draw the element in centered mode, making sure that you have the correctly mirrored distance from the starting point. If you right-click on the Line Tool box button, or if you hold the left mouse button, then you can select from the different other tools, like the Curve tool. With this, you can create simple three-point curves. In the first step, a straight line is drawn, and in a third step, you define the strength of the curve. The Freeform Line tool is used to create shapes that consist of multiple straight lines like polygons. With every click, a new line is added. This can even be mixed with the freehand lines when holding the mouse button and starting to draw. These freehand drawn lines will also support the Pixel Perfect option to draw clean shapes. The tool stops working when you either close the polygon or if you hit Enter or Escape. The Freeform Solid tool is also used to draw polygons or freeform shapes the same way as with the Freeform Line tool, but the shapes are filled. The Auto Close option will automatically finish the shape even if you did not close it yourself. It just draws a straight line from the position where you stopped drawing to the position where you started. This also means that you cannot draw straight lines, but that's okay. Instead, you can quickly create freehand filled shapes to color your artwork. Let's have a look at a basic workflow for such coloring with this sketch of a girl. We create a separate layer and call it Color. Now we can draw shapes to apply the coloring for certain areas. We could also use the Fill tool, but this requires that the sketch uses perfectly closed lines, which isn't always the case, and so the color would bleed into areas where you don't want it to be. Instead, we draw the different colors shape by shape on top of each other. Of course, there's the need for some fine-tuning on pixel level, but as you can see, we can get results very quickly with just this single tool. You could also use the different layers to create the different shapes and merge them later. The R key selects the rectangle tool, which will allow us to draw hollow rectangles and squares. Holding the Control key will create a centered rectangle around the position we started drawing. Shift will enable the square mode, and if we hold Control and Shift, then we can create a centered square. The Extended Edit option will enable you to create a rectangle as well, but it will not be immediately drawn. Instead, it shows different handles that you can use for different sorts of modifying the size. Again, have a look at the bottom line of the main window where you hover over such a handle to see extra key options. For example, the Shift key will maintain the aspect ratio when resizing with that handle. If you move your mouse outside, then you can rotate the rectangle. When rotating, the Shift key activates an angle snapping. You can finalize the editing by using the Enter key. And there's also a tool to create filled rectangles. There are different fill modes that we will explain in a later video. By default, the rectangle is just filled with the color that you have selected. As always, the left mouse button uses the primary color, and the right mouse button uses the second color. I often use this tool to remove unwanted pixels. I hit Shift-R and use the right mouse button with the second color being the transparent one. The circle tools work exactly the same way as the rectangle tools do, but they just draw ovals and circles. Holding the Shift key creates circles like it created squares with the rectangle tools. Control key creates centered ovals, and in combination with Shift, you can draw circles with the center point. Filled circles are of course possible as well. The next tool can be used to fill an area with a color or pattern. By default, an isolated filling is applied when you click on a pixel. It will find all connected pixels from that position sharing the same color index and apply the new color to all these pixels. If you disable the isolated fill option, then the tool will apply the new color to all pixels in the image that currently use the color of the pixel you click on. Let's go to the tree layer to show the differences by example. First, I use the isolated fill mode to only modify portions that are limited by pixels using different colors. Now I uncheck this option and all the pixels using the color I clicked on will turn orange, no matter where they are on the layer. So you can quickly change colors of the tree trunk and the branches. Sometimes you want to modify not only a single color, but also those that are very similar. For example, to just reduce the colors that are used in an area. To do this, you can use the Tolerance option. It's initially set to 0, so it only matches exact colors. If you increase the value, then it will include more colors being similar with respect to the given tolerance. The Layers option defines if the detection of pixels that are to be filled should be done on the current layer only, or use all layers that are visible. By default, the option is disabled, and so only the pixels of the active layer are considered. To show the difference, I deactivate most of the layer so that we have the tree only, and I also disable the background color, which turns transparent pixels into a checker pattern. Filling on a transparent pixel on one of the top level blossom leaves layers will turn all transparent pixels that are connected to the starting pixel into orange. It will ignore the contents of the other layers completely. When I enable the Layers option and do the same fill, then you could see that although the orange pixels are drawn in the current layer, the detection of the transparent pixels are taking all the other visible layers into account. The filling stops on any non-transparent pixel, leading to a different result. For the rest of the video, I'll be drawing a post office with all the tools we learned so far. That's all for now. Next video is all about colors, color gradients, and fill patterns. Thanks for watching. If you're interested in the series, then please like and subscribe.